Hello everybody, welcome back again to Mr. Wisp 254. In today's lesson, I want us to go through how you can be able to set up a guest Wi-Fi and have it completely isolated from your main network. So you want to do this because you definitely don't want something malicious from a guest gadget coming in and maybe infecting your local network. And generally, you're also doing this for security purposes because you don't want somebody to gain access to your main network. So this is how we are going to go about it. First of all, you're going to come to wireless, then come to security profiles. Let's create a security profile that the guest Wi-Fi is going to use. So we add a profile. Let's call this guest profile. The mode here is going to be dynamic keys, and the authentication type is going to be WPA2. The pre-shared key, let's set it to guest 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and click OK on that. So the next thing that you'd want to do is come to Wi-Fi interfaces, and then now what we now need to do is to create a different SSID that the guest is going to use to log into to get access to the internet. So you're going to create a virtual Wi-Fi interface. So let's give this a name, let's say guest WLAN. The mode is going to be access point, and the security profile we are going to change this to guest profile, and for the SSID let's give it the name guest. That's all that you need to do, then click apply. Okay, it's going to kick me out for a second or so. Let's see if it does that. Good, it hasn't. So the next thing that I want us to do is you need to come to the bridge. So that we now need to create a bridge, and on that bridge we are going to put all the interfaces that we want to use the guest Wi-Fi. So let's create a bridge. Let's call this guest bridge. Okay, then let's come to the ports. So the ports that we are going to use, we are going to use the guest WLAN, the bridge. This is going to go to the guest bridge. Okay, and also let's just also add maybe one port. Let's use port 4, ether 4 that is, and the bridge is also going to be guest bridge. Click OK on that. So after that, the next thing that you need to do is you now need to create to give the bridge an IP. So you come to IP, IP addresses, then now let's add an IP. So let's use 10.10.10.1/24, and this is going to go to our bridge, guest bridge. Click apply and okay. So after that, the next thing that you want to do is you want to create a DHCP server that is going to be used by your guests. So you need to come to IP, DHCP server. This is not supposed to be here. So you need to come to DHCP and then DHCP setup. So the setup is going to be on the guest bridge. Then next, that looks okay. Next, next. So this is going to be the range that the guests are going to be given. Next, 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 That was successful. That's okay. So let's get rid of that. So the next thing that we now want to do so that we can be able to completely isolate the clients, the guest clients from our main network, you need to create just one firewall rule that is going to enable you to achieve that. So you come to IP firewall. First of all, let's not the IP that we gave to the guests. So the address, the source address is 10.10.10.0/24. It's the whole block. Then masquerade. Okay. So after that, you need to come to now the filter rules. And we only need one rule for this to be effective. So the chain is going to be forward. And our source address, this is now going to be, let me just open the address list so that you see where I'm getting them from. IP addresses. So our source address is going to be this, the guest bridge network. So it's going to be 10.10.10.0/24, and our destination address is going to be our local bridge now, which is 41.41.41.0/24. So this is going to be 41.41.41.0/24. And the action for this is going to be drop. So basically what means is that anybody who has this IP given to them 10.10.10.0/24 and is trying to get to 41.41.41.0/24, the action for that should be drop. So we apply that and okay. So we are going to test and see if this works. So actually what I have hooked up to my router, I have a second router that is hooked up. Let's come to new Winbox. And as you can see, I have two routers here. So this is my current router where I'm logged into. You can see my IP is 41.1. You can also see the session that I have on top here. This is 41.1. So the other MikroTik device that is hooked to my current one is 41.248. So let's see if we can be able to log into that. You can see that I'm able to log into this other MikroTik device. And you can also be able to see that they are different. This is a hex PoE light and this is a hub light. So I want us now to connect to the guest Wi-Fi and see if we can be able to reach this second MikroTik that is connected to us. So what we need to do is you need to come to wireless. And then let's see if, yeah, guest. So let's connect to this. Connect. It's going to ask us for a password. Guest 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. I'm going to click yes on that. Yeah, so we are connected. So let's see if we can be able to connect back to the second device that is connected to our MikroTik device. So you can see that I'm unable to log in. And if we come back to the first MikroTik, let's cancel this and let's refresh and see the neighbors. So you see that we don't have any neighbor appearing here. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is how you can be able to accomplish this. So it's a really simple process, and with that, at least you have some form of security that the guests are not able to get into your core network and maybe do some malicious things or something like that. So that's it for today. Thank you, and please subscribe to the channel. Bye bye.